Subscribe to MasterChef Mom and press the bell icon to get all the recipe updates.
Hello all, the festival season is truly upon us. We had Rakhi, Janmashtami, Ganesh Chaturthi, now Navratras are coming, Dashera, Diwali, Christmas, which means we all have to work harder, hit the gym harder.
What?
That's because Uma is going to make so many sweets and snacks that I have to work harder to stay in shape.
In fact, Raghu, today I'm going to share a super delicious but super easy to make 7 cup burfi or 7 cup cake recipe. And it's easy to make, but it's super delicious, a super hit recipe. I can't wait to show it.
I know. Shall we start?
Yeah, let's start cooking this.
This sweet is called 7 cup cake because we are measuring all the ingredients in the same cup. I've used 100 ml cups to measure all the ingredients, and there are 7 cups. Now 3 cups of sugar, 1 cup of grated coconut, 1 cup of besan, 1 cup of milk, 1 cup of ghee. And this grated coconut, you can use fresh coconut or you can even use desiccated coconut. And for flavoring, I'm going to use cardamom. You can use flavor of your choice, but I prefer using cardamom. Now, let's start making the 7 cup cake. Yeah, so first step, we're going to lightly roast the besan. So this will remove the raw taste of the besan. This is an important step. So
how much time should we roast it?
So we will start getting a light aroma, fragrance from this. Till that time, that's it. Not till it becomes very brown or anything. So approximately around 5 minutes on low flame. And the ghee also I heated in the morning. So fresh ghee makes the sweet more tasty. So if the ghee is fresh, then the 7 cup comes out very well. In fact, Raghu, this recipe we made 2 years ago when Amma came here. We made this live on Instagram and it became viral, and so many of them made this 7 cup cake. Because there is no need for sugar syrup in this recipe. All ingredients you put together, mix, and you get this burfi. So even people who are, you know, starting to cook, or amateurs, bachelors, staying alone, everyone can make this sweet.
Easy to make.
Easy to make. Okay, now it's become fragrant. It's roasted nicely. Now I'm going to add the next 2 cups. That is coconut and milk. And also I'm going to add sugar. All the 3.
So first cup was besan, second cup was coconut, third cup was milk.
Yeah.
Now fourth cup is the first cup of sugar.
Yeah, first cup of sugar. You can add the other 2 cups also.
5, 6 cups done. Only the ghee is pending.
Yeah, only the ghee is pending. So now we are going to mix this well.
Still on low flame, huh?
Yeah. Better to make the entire sweet on low flame. So we are going to mix it well so that there are no lumps.
Should I grease the plates in the meanwhile?
Yeah.
Both of them?
Yeah, both the plates you can grease. So you can use 1 teaspoon of ghee in the plate and grease it nicely on the sides also. Yeah.
What is the reason we grease the plate?
So that when you make, when you pour this
and spread it,
you inside this, and when it sets, and then you're going to cut it into pieces, squares, right?
Yeah.
So it will come out nicely without sticking to the...
It won't get stuck.
Yeah, without sticking to the plate.
You can actually cut and remove and actually eat it in nice shapes.
Yeah. So the sugar is melted, Raghu, nicely now. I'm going to add the ghee. You keep mixing it. I'm going to add the ghee.
7th cup.
And I'm also going to add the cardamom powder. That's it. Mix it well.
Mm.
That's it. Now this has to come together well.
It looks divine.
It's easy to make, not complicated at all. Just the 7 cups, that's it. So even if you want to gift, make these burfis and gift sweets to your neighbors, friends. Best sweet to make. You can make it in larger quantities and you can distribute it. Easy to make. Better than store-bought ones, sweets.
So these kind of got mixed into it.
No? Yeah. Nicely it's got.
Cardamom, I can smell the cardamom. So Uma, till the time you get that texture, it sets, you have to keep stirring, huh?
Yeah, you have to keep stirring. That is till it becomes non-stick. Still you can see that it's sticking to the...
Yeah.
So it has to completely not stick. Till that time we are going to keep mixing. And even after you put it in the plate and you're not able to shape it or anything like that, then what you have to do is put it back into the kadai, mix again. That means it needs to stay for a few more minutes. You have taken it early. That's all. These are the two things that you have to be careful. Most people get only this place, they get it wrong. That's it, it's done. Now we'll pour it into the plates.
With that non-sticky consistency.
Yeah, it's thick. Yeah. So that's it, it's done. Now we're going to immediately pour this, transfer it into the trays. If we want, we can do it off in this tray itself. I'm going to do a little bit in this.
So it depends if you want thicker pieces or thinner pieces.
Yeah, based on that. Now we'll just tap this. Okay, and let it cool down for 7 minutes, for 7 to 8 minutes. Then we'll
cut it into
just cut it and leave it. After it completely cools, then we can remove the pieces. Okay. So now it's been around 5 minutes, and I'm just applying some ghee to the knife. If it's uneven ragu, you can use a spoon, back of the spoon, and press it to level it. But this is, ours is already leveled, so I'm not.
It looks beautiful.
Yeah, so. The desired shapes, square or...
So if you actually cut it into small pieces, it's easy to store it also.
Yeah. And you can have smaller pieces every time.
So you will feel less guilty.
Grease it, and sharp knife is better. And just like this. Quickly. Okay. And this maybe we can shape it like diamonds. Making it more small pieces. That's it. So we'll wait for it to cool completely and then we'll remove the pieces.
Okay.
Yeah. So Raghu, it's cooled down. Let me remove one. Come out well.
We're waiting for this.
How is
it? Yummy.
I also taste it too.
Telling you. Please try it out immediately. Kids at your house are going to love it. I'm talking about the older kids also. They're just going to love it. Do try it and give your feedback to Ma.
Yeah, do try and share your feedback with me. We'll see you soon with another delicious recipe. Till then, happy cooking.
Have a great festival season ahead. Bye.